Hello and welcome to Dell's Gaming. I'm Dell and this is From the Depths Designer. This is a quick, may not be quick, but this is a part of the HowTo series of videos, and in this episode we'll be looking at how we blow stuff up. Because, you know, it's okay building stuff, but what we really want to do is destroy the other stuff in the game, really. So, we're going to look at how we go about that. Now, if you have been following the basics of some of the game, you'll have worked out the interface, which I'll bring up, and possibly how to build a basic hull, you know, something that actually floats without turning upside down, you know, just a basic boat, and an engine that's got some power in it, etc. And now you're thinking, right, okay, I can now go blow other things up and make them go boom. Because that's part of the game. It's actually a very big part of the game, etc. So let's go and have a look. Now, I've put here a chair, which allows me to sit in the chair and be a little bit more stable. Because now once I'm stable in the chair, you'll notice the boat is still moving, but the camera isn't. It moves with the boat, which is good. So, what we're going to look at is a couple of basic weapons. Just the basics of shooting things, how you get them to shoot, what can be used to shoot other vehicles. Without going too advanced, we will look at more advanced subjects on some of the items in different videos. So, the basic starting point, if we go into build mode, to add something to our ship. So we've got a little target out there, which is it's not quite side on. I might put another one which is side on. The weapons that we have available to us, we'll start down this end. If we go in, press E and bring up the E menu, down on the left hand side, after the blocks and the air and the control and the resources and the engines, we have simple weapons. Now if we go back to less, you start with just a simple ram and large cannon. The ram is a fairly simple device. You put it on the front of your ship and you ram. It's very simple. Now, a ram has a number of good benefits. If we go back to the build menu, it has a very good health. If you look on there, for its size, it has 500 health, which is very good. And a good armor value of 10, which is equivalent to metal. Its weight is 0.4, so it's equivalent to a metal block. So it's a very good, and it's got this ability, basically, of damages 2x the mass of the velocity. So the bigger your ship and the faster it is going, the more damage you will do when you crash into a ship with your rams. Now the rams don't have to be just pointed forward. You can put your rams on the side and they will also have an effect. So if you have a glancing blow onto a ship, they would still be effective in this particular design, you know. So put them on the side. You can have more than one row, and each of your rams as it hits will transfer some of your velocity and mass as damage. They're good on either very fast ships or very big ships. Ideally, a very big fast ship, but you know, we can't always guarantee having that side. So that's your first close-in weapon, but you've got to get close in the first place. And if you haven't got a fast ship, you might have to deal with your enemy at some range. So what other vehicles, what other options have we got? So if we go back to the E menu, so we're in the day one, we have the large cannon. The large cannon is the basic go-to weapon of our of your designs. It's like your standard, let me just bring that down there a bit, it's like your standard gun that you would expect to use on any sailing ship, and you will see these on some of the early starter sailing ships. It hasn't got a lot of damage. If we go back into the menu, armor piercing 4, so excuse me, it's not going to be piercing metal, let's put it that way. With an armor piercing value of 4, it's good against wooden targets. Kinetic damage 400, so if it connects, it's going to do 400 damage, which is okay. And the shot velocity is 60, isn't very fast. So, but it is a starting weapon. If we now to use the weapons, if we've got this weapon here now, there's a couple of ways of using it. If we come out of the build menu, basically, if you are close enough to a weapon, if you look on the bottom left hand side, you will see we have the scroll menu and we have the option for all. Now it will now follow my cursor and try to fire in the air. Now it's saying no ammo, and you're going, well, I've got my gun, I need me ammo, why is it? Well, basically you're missing one vital component. If we go back to the build menu and go into resources, ammo barrels. Basically, you need ammo to fire your weapons. And an ammo barrel stores your ammo. It also automatically generates a little bit of ammo every second. So if you look down on our right-hand side, the top graphical menu is our ammo. It's got, looks like, 3 shotgun shells. Obviously, I can't move my cursor there. But we've now got 500 ammo. So now, when I go to back to the gun and aim at our target, we're firing a shell. Now, it's not very long distance, and you've got to, there's no aiming reticule. And one other problem is, you can see, I can't actually aim at that target because it's out of my arc of fire. So, okay, maybe it's going near my front arc of fire. So we'll think, let's put some guns on the front, because guns on the front is also good. So we'll put a couple of guns on the front. So we hold the tab button down and move it around a little bit. So we'll put a couple of guns on the front as well for coming in, and obviously there for the broadside. So we come out of here and the guns at the front aren't aiming. Why is that? Well, when, first of all, as the base, most basic level, we're not close enough. So if we go back to our character, get out of our chair, and wander up here, and this is very like much a first person view of it, now our guns do follow where we are aiming. Within reason. You can see still, they haven't got the angle. They've got a reasonable range. We are having to aim very high, but this is like effectively your first person. Now you can also see the ammo on the right hand side has gone down to 0. So I've run out of ammo on my vessel. So the ammo barrels have, but they've just suddenly regenerated, because that's what it does. So let's just fire some more. Now we can fire again. If I point at the ship, you can see the ammo going up and down. Right, we might be able to broadside with the other weapon now. So if we go back here and go into the other view, okay, we can now broadside with this one. So, okay, what this is showing is that when we fire a weapon, the we had a bounce, we managed to just, it's just off. You can see it's turning our vessel. So the force of the gun is causing your vessel to turn. That's because we have physics. It's not torqueless. I mean, a gun will have an effect on your ship. So if you had a side broadside of 1,000 guns, which is a silly number, but hey-ho, you could sort of seriously make your vessel move around in the water because of the sheer number of guns you've got in your vessel. So so that's the first point to remember when you're using any of your vessels or any of your guns, that when you shoot your gun,
It has a recoil, and that recoil is applied to your ship and makes it move around. So just to be aware, not really an issue with these small guns. Can be an issue when you get to really, really big guns. If you look at some of my videos, I've got some ones with some really, really big guns, and they have a big recoil, and they I've seen some ships actually fly backwards because the guns fire and have so much recoil they make the ship go backwards. Okay, that's the large cannon. Let's go and have a look at something else. Whoops, sorry, let's put into build mode, then go E. Now we're going to increase the more button here, so we're going to increase to the slightly more advanced ones. Now we've got this small cannon. Let's have a look at this small cannon. So we turn it to face outwards, and we'll put it here. Now what we're going to do is we're going to put two down there. Okay, let's get back into the character. So this is the small cannon, and as the name would suggest, it's small. Strange that, isn't it? But one good thing is it's got quite a nice, it's a lot shorter and not as good a range. It fires faster. It's not got very good range at all. You can see it's hardly, can't even reach that target. But it turns a little quicker, and it has got a slightly wider arc of fire. Not much, but enough. The large cannon was not able to fire at that target. Our small one just about is. So that's the small cannon. If we go and look at the stats, I keep on hitting the wrong button, and I do apologise about that. I forgot I wasn't. Let's see, kinetic damage 200, so that's half of the large cannon. The armour piercing value is 3, so that's even lower, so it's didn't have problems piercing even wood, but it would hit. But it's got a good reload time. A 4, shot velocity 25 is worse, that's why it's got a very short range. Good thing about the small cannon is it fires faster, uses less ammo. So you can fire more times. Now you can mix your weapons. If we go back over here and we put a small cannon either side of the big cannon for no apparent reason. And then let's come off here and get my little avatar. Come on. Come on, there we go, over here. Now, you'll notice down at the bottom it says 3. So, if I fire, all 3 shots hit. But this is going to be a bit awkward, because they've all got different trajectories. They're not all aiming at the same point. Let me try and get to somewhere. So you can see they're all sort of aiming at different points, got different ways of travelling. So it's not really going to be very effective. And we'll go through, but you can do it. So that's how you could control like lots of them. What else have we got? Let's go and find something else. Let's see. Right. Torpedo launchers. Torpedo launcher, why not? Let's put a torpedo launcher on the front. Let's be a PT boat style of ship. So we can put a couple of torpedo launchers on there. Now if we go back to the menu, torpedo launcher, there's not really much technical info on this one, but if we go back to our character and once more go up ahead, now this is, torpedoes are, well, frankly they are torpedoes. Now down on the menu you see you've got an option number 5, it's automatically put it into group number 5 if I get close enough to it. Are we? Oh no, there we go, it's put it in that one, that's fine. Now, if I just aim forward, and let's see what we can... You can see the little torpedoes fly out there, and they will aim at the target and try and track it, and as the name suggests, they are a torpedo. They will go under the water. Did they actually hit? I'm not sure. Let's see if we can get some more out there firing away. Let me just try and get some more, and we'll track them this time. So we can watch these firing away. Are they under the water here somewhere? Oops, we can see them going down.
They didn't quite track the target. They've got a very narrow range, like the other ones, but they've got quite long range. You can see they're still going. They are still flying, or swimming, or going under the water, tracking. So that's not too bad. They've got a reasonable range, and they are under the water, which is quite interesting, and they are guided. So if we were to turn our ship around enough, we could find that they would just track the target. So they're good against sea targets. What else have we got? Oops, hitting the wrong button again. Bear with me. Missile launchers. Missiles! My favourite. Yeah, not necessarily this particular one, but I like missiles. So, missile launchers are a laser-guided missile. I will bring my character up to the missile. Now you can see there is a nice laser beam here, which we can put onto the target, and we're just out of... There we go. It's gone green. If I now fire, you'll notice it will track the target. Yay! We have a hit, and we'll fire again. So, not got a lot of damage. But the fact that it tracks you wherever you are pointed with good accuracy, it's up to you as to how good you are at aiming at that missile. And it's, as you can tell, it's got quite a wide range. You know, that's a good 45 degrees out there, and that comes through. Range is quite good as well in general. So this is a good little weapon. Damage of the missile. If we go back here and go over the top, we have it's no data. Damage is it's somewhere in between. Let's say it's equivalent to a small cannon, but it's got that good damage. Right, but it's got that good accuracy because it's down to you where you point that laser. Okay, next one. The harpoon gun. Now the harpoon gun is an interesting one. Has use specifically for a specific purpose. I don't know if we've got this. It has got a very short range. Basically, it does no damage because it is a harpoon gun. Now, we're not going hunting whales, but if I aim at our target and fire, look, where are we? Let's see if we can get it. Well, we'll just aim like that. It's fired everything except that. Let me just give it a thing. I'll go through this in a second just so I can just want to make sure I only target this. Okay, so if we go like that and fire. No. Apologies. Is it right? Is it turned it the wrong way around? No, no. That is right. Okay. Right, so we can see it's aiming over and can't aim in that direction. Okay, now we can see there's a chain on the end of this like harpoon, as the name suggests. It hasn't got a very good long range, but basically if it does hit something, it will then pull it towards your ships. So an ideal place for this actually would be near your rams. You fire it at a ship and it pulls the ship into your rams. And it wouldn't do a lot of damage, but it would pull them up. And also your cannons, etc., would be here quite happily hitting that particular target. So that is another one. At the moment, it's not very good for using with the AI, which we'll go through. But if you've got close enough, you can make sure that that fast ship doesn't get away from you. So it has a value, it does have value. Right, let's have a look. What else have we got in our lovely area? Now, drills is a whole section in itself. So we will leave drills at this moment because that is a slightly more complex and comes under complex damage dealing, really. We'll choose the laser because it is another fairly simple device. Now, one issue with the laser... we'll just put that on the front, is very simple. It's as accurate as you would expect from a laser, but it has one basic problem. If we go down here, is it doesn't move with where my aim. Basically, if I pump it up, it takes a little while to fire, and it only fires in the direction that it is placed. Which is fine when we start getting onto turrets and other weapons. Or, if you'll just aim the whole, you know, you could put a bank of these on the front, just aim your ship at the target, and then unleash and fire. And that would be really good, you know. That would be a very good way of firing your missile. Now, obviously it's reloading, you can see the little things pumping away on there, and then it fires. So there is a delayed action on its firing, but, you know, that's what you get for having a very long range, very accurate gun. Have we got anything left? Right, under the simple weapons, we have the autocannon. Now, the autocannon, if we put it, where should we put it? Let's put it over here. Now, the autocannon, let's move it back over here. You can see it basically is a multi-barreled cannon. If I get back into my person and go over to it, here we are. We have our autocannon. We'll just see which numbers it on. It's on 3. Okay, just so I know. We'll go through those numbers in a second. So, again, there's no aiming. It's fixed. But when I fire, you can see it fires like a bit like a machine gun. It also has a nice little... I don't know if you can just see there. There is a green beam coming out of it, which is basically telling you where it's going to fire. So that's a nice little autocannon machine gun type of effect that has. Again, we can have a look at the damage. 50 damage per shot. On each of those shots, there's a 50 damage. So it's not great, but it fires lots of them, which is good. Armor piercing, very low. So only use this against wooden ships. Against anything else, anything with metal, basically, we'll just shrug these off and they just won't do any damage whatsoever. But reload time is very good and shot velocity is very good. Shot velocity means it goes a good distance, and the reload time means you can shoot it again very quickly. The ammo use is also very low, and shots 9 means theoretically you could do 450 damage, which is more than a large cannon, and you're shooting more times per second. So it's theoretical, you know, DPS is higher, but that assumes you connect and damage. Now, obviously we've set all these weapons out, but what if I had, I'm just going to clean this up a little bit. What if I didn't have all these different weapons and we'd set our ship up to basically try and in the old style of ships, you know, we wanted to set ourselves up with a broadside on either side of our ship. So we now have a broadside there, and then we'll I should have put the mirror line on, obviously, but I forgot about it, so we'll go do it, just do it this way. So we've got two sets of guns for when we get to the broadside of our target. But if we get into our come out of here, if I'm not going to want to, we have 13 now. Depending on the distance, the range you are to your gun, if I put myself back in the seat, we can see we've actually got 8 guns here. You can see as I move around, not all the guns are aiming where I want them to go. Which is no good, because I want to shoot more than just 4 guns. I want to shoot all my guns. So how can we do that? Well, the simplest way to do that is with a controller, a fire control. So if we go back into the build menu, bring it up, go to your controls, and do the fire control computer. Now, if we just put that behind my seat, it can go anywhere. For the moment, just for no reason, we'll put it behind. Now, when I go back into my character, You can see when I select all, I have all 18 guns. Now, what it basically means is the fire computer simply looks at the number of the gun, which you'll go through in a second, and allows you to control all of the guns under that same number. Now, at the moment, I'm on the all factor. And there they go. Oh, not all of them. I just used all the ammo up, which is not good. But you can see the ammo. I would need more ammo barrels to start producing more ammo. Basic level. But we can now control our guns. Now, okay, that's cool. Let's now take this a level further of what if you only wanted to control some of the guns, or you've bring a slightly different option in. We have got multiple types of cannon, so we've got our small ones and we've got our big ones. Now, we don't want to shoot all of them at the same time, because the small ones are for short range and the big ones are for long range. So we don't want to shoot them all at the same time, because that would be just basically ineffective, trying to fire all of the cannons at once. As you can see, it goes all over the place. No, not very good. So let's see what you can do. Is if you go up to them, we can press the Q button, and then you can see here you have a select your weapon control. So if I put them on one, and now if I put the small cannon on two, you'll notice down on the left hand side we have the one and a two. So if I now go to the one, I'm now only limiting my control to that one gun. Now you can obviously put this one on the number one as well, and straight away. So as you can see, you could put all of these on the number one. I won't do all of them, but just to give you the idea. So now number one means my heavy cannons are on the side, and you can obviously do the same on the other side. So we've got farming all our heavy cannons. Now if I go to number two by scrolling my mouse, we're only now firing the small cannon. So again, we can lump all our small cannons together on number two. And control them all together. So here we are. Four. There we go. So that's how. Now you can obviously have a different number then for some of the missiles or torpedoes. So you can decide, oh, okay, we're heading towards the enemy, so torpedoes at the front could be on number three, as an example. Or you can move between. So you can basically, you could fire your number four and then go down and then fire your number two. You, in that situation, you could just put it on all, but as we said, you know, it's difficult. If it was close enough, that most probably wouldn't matter, but you can see the difference in range there. You would want to aim differently. So this one you might want to aim fairly low, and the small ones you might want to aim a bit higher to get the same range and target. So this is very much first person usage of the guns. What other guns are available, or whatever weapons are there to make to shoot our target? Right, we'll just do a basic look at what else is available. There's three other areas. One is missiles. Now, missiles are, when we start getting to these, we're starting to get into multi-block weapons. What I mean by that is you have to build up your weapon. It's not simply a matter of place one block and you have a missile. You have to start building together controllers, launch pads, etc. So we're not going to go fully into how missiles are built in this particular episode, but simplistically, if I put a missile controller down, I'll just put it there, and a launch pad and some missile blocks, that's about as simple, we'll just put it, make it a four, about as simple as you can go as far as a missile. And then we'll put it onto, using our new Q, we'll put it onto number three. So now if we come out on number 3 we will have one missile. And this is a fairly simple missile. Now we can fairly much aim at our target. And you can see the missile sort of, well, it went into the water. Which is not necessarily good in this particular case. Let's just put that up a little bit. See if we can get it to... Oh, it's hitting our own raft. That's not good. Now, among all of the blocks, we won't go to full missiles here. I will do that on a totally separate items. But you've got quite a few options here. If we go back into inventory, you've got, which need to be looked at, laser emitters, identify friend or foe, that would have stopped it hitting our own raft, staggered fire, missile winches, missile six-way connectors. This allows you to connect more than one missile to a block, so you can, from one point, you can have six, you know, three missiles all firing off of an item. Just a very quick, this is just a quick one, quick demonstration. So, you know, we've got all three and it fires all three. So there's quite a few unusual options you can do. You can also customize your missiles. Again, won't go into those. You've got lots of different warheads, lots of options to investigate on the missile. So we have missiles, much more powerful than the simple weapons, longer range and very customizable. You can make them fast, you can make them long range, you can make them powerful, you can make them agile. You basically build your missiles. And I've got some videos up about creating missiles, but we will do a more advanced how-to on that later. The next on the build menu, we have custom cannons. Now, custom cannons are basically, as the name suggests, customizing a cannon. You can see they've got quite a few options here, and that is a lot of complexity here, and it's very easy to make something which simply does not work. I'm going to do a very, very simple cannon here. Let's just go for a simple round the side. There we go. And this is a very quick and cannon. So six-way, a firing piece. The firing piece is like the breech block equivalent. I'm just going to give it some barrels. And barrels is obviously, you know, you're putting barrels onto a gun like you would any type of gun. And then we will just give it some ammo. There we go. And we will give it number 4. So again, you can go very complex on this. If I come out of here and now do number 4, you can see how the barrel of the gun, sorry, moving a bit quick there, is following my cursor. It hasn't got a very good reload speed at this moment. We are waiting. There we go, it's reloaded again. Because this is a very basic starter cannon. I've done nothing to this. It's much larger than the other guns, but already it's got a kinetic damage of 165, armor piercing of 3. So by looking at the breech block, I see what the ability of this gun is. You can see it's gonna have a much better range. Now you can get these guns to fire at a very high rate, very high damage. I mean, we're looking at firing like a machine gun, and damage, you can also make it damage like it's a, you know, a proper big cannon, and armor piercing, get the armor piercing up so that it will penetrate metal without a problem. So lots of options here. Again, if we go into the build menu quickly, and we just go back to that menu, I'm not going to go through all of these. I will put custom cannons into a separate section, but you can see you've got barrels which increase accuracy, recoil, reduce your recoil, reduce your visibility with flash, motor-driven barrels that increases the amount that the barrel moves when you point at a target. Elevation, as the name suggests, elevation. Gauge actually just increases the size of your shot. And then we have special warheads, you know, explosive warheads, armor piercing, and just general ammo. Including a predictor. Now the predictor is a nice simple one. If I just put that on there, boom, it makes it a lot easier for me when I'm back in here, because now you can see I've got a nice little bit there that I can just put the white line on the target, and there we go, that should fairly much hit there. Oh, just short, there we go. Is that done a hit? So basically that predictor is basically showing where the gun would hit. Range wise and etc, the more barrels you put on, the better. You're not limited to one. We can put there is guns out there with up to 100 barrels, but you know, 40-50 barrels is pretty big, but not unheard of, you know, bigger than the size of this ship. So you can have fun with cannons. Experiment with all of those blocks to make it fire fast and far and very big damage, etc. Enough to blow your opposition out of the water. What else have we got? Okay, one which definitely we will look on a different one is lasers. Now, lasers are most probably the most advanced system on the system in the weapons. It's not a matter, you need to combine quite a few items in here. Now there is a tutorial available, the laser guide, and I would advise anyone when they're going through doing lasers to look at these laser guides. The same with the custom cannons, there is a cannon guide. And under missiles, there is a missile guide, and I would advise people to go through those. And we will do a slightly more in-depth on how these all work together to build a very basic laser system. I think even on here, I most probably haven't got enough power. One big difference on here is that lasers are very much affected by the power of your engine. All the other guns here just use ammo. It's just ammo that makes these guns fire. A laser will be limited by how much power your engine gives out. So you will need to build very big engines to have good laser systems. So that is a very big important factor. It's also why lasers are used later on in your campaign or game, when you have a big ships with big engines, you know, so that they can support a very large laser system. There is an assumption, oh, I built this backwards, doesn't really matter. There is a certain assumption level that you know how to build a big ship, etc. So that's why we're not going to go into the lasers now. We'll do that as a starting. My suggestion is, first of all, learn to use the simple weapons. They are still good at the very early stages, but you do have to be very close. In the campaign, to be frankly honest, I think they're mostly not worth it, except as secondary guns. The next possibly best one is to learn missiles. Missiles are relatively easy to shoot and track, and they're fairly easy to build. And take this easy in the first person view here to just basically aim your missiles at something. It's fairly easy in regard once you get it set up, and they do a fair bit of damage, and you haven't got to worry about being too accurate with your shot. You can just fire and hit your target. So definitely missiles. When you start to want to do some real big damage, start looking into the big cannons. That's when you will start to get some very long range and consistent quick damage on your targets. Still haven't hit him. Oh, I'm come on, let's see if I can just determined to get one shot in with the cannon. It's just annoying. Obviously you can build the cannon up to be very, very powerful. Oh, just short. Oh, typical. Improve the size of your cannon and it will be a lot simpler. Quite simply. It's just, that's not going to help me too much. Not at this level of cannon. There we go. Okay. So that's the basic weapons. Using a fire control computer. How to set the weapons to have a different number here. So you can define and shoot separate weapons using your mouse scroll button. You can now try and fire all the weapons. You can see that did all, and it fired the missiles as well as the cannon all at the same time. Or you can isolate it to just the weapons you want. By selecting the particular weapons. So that's great. So remember, that's under control, fire control computer. Your basic missile system. Have a look at the missile guide, but these can also go vertically. There's lots of arrangements you can put with your missiles. And your cannons. You can build up some very nice cannons. Now, there is one other section with most of these items. We've got firing in a particular direction, and this will also be a separate section, but you can build these onto turrets. In the build menu, there is an option for, under new object, for turrets, and we will go through those as again in most probably the next video, actually, when we start looking at custom cannons. We might not worry about it about missiles, but we might do this for custom cannons next. And we'll look at turreting a cannon. A turret is ideal quite simply because it will turn to face the enemy, just like a tank turret or a ship turret, etc., as the name suggests, you know, as people are used to having seeing turrets. They can turn around and aim at your target no matter what. So in this particular instance, where I'm limited by the angle of my ship, I wouldn't be by putting it on a turret. So let's watch out for that in our next video, which I think our next one will be custom cannons and turrets. So it's turrets and custom cannons. Just making a note of that, sorry, just to make sure I do it in the right order, next one. So, hopefully that's been a reasonable intro into how to make things go boom. I haven't succeeded in making that go boom. I should really move my ship a little closer. But, you know, it's just how to fire the weapons here. I like my missiles. You'll notice if you watch my videos, I use missiles a lot. It's just a sort of, for want of a better word, a decision I made to try using missiles a lot in a lot of my ships rather than lasers and cannons. I do use a lot of cannons as well. So we'll go through some of that in more detail. Hopefully you've enjoyed the video or learnt something. Please click that like button and leave any comments down below. Wait for the next video and we will move our ships a little bit further and get you started in the campaign eventually. So until next time, keep playing, keep building, and have fun.